Hey, what's up, guys? It's Bobo Bird here. I'm gonna be starting a new dynasty on NCAA 13. I'm gonna be using Ole Miss, and I've noticed that most of my games this year, or in this season, are gonna be at home. We got an A-plus schedule, so we're gonna be facing some hard teams, and we're on a Heisman mode, I believe. And I've only had 4 minutes quarters, so we get things done quick, and I'm gonna look at the uniforms first. I haven't looked at them yet. They look pretty good, even though they look the same. I'm gonna go with these. This is our first game. It's gonna be at home, like most of ours are. And yeah, you guys probably been thinking about Super Bowl lately because it was just on yesterday. That was a great game. Kind of picked a better game, plus with them being twins, that's even better. Hope you guys liked that one. I know I did, but I did not like most of the commercials this year. They weren't that good this year. And the main one I liked was the Leon Sandcastle. Laughed my ass off on that one. And also a good one was the David Letterman with Andrew Luck. I like that one.
This campus has been
going to start our first game against the Baylor Bears.
Hemingway Stadium in Oxford, Mississippi.
The first game of the season. Way to start off.
Big time head clashing, getting set to go from Oxford. That's going to wrap it up here in the studio, but we'll be here to keep you up to date on everything else going on in college football throughout our games.
And they're going to kick
ESPN's college football.
Brent we'll Nessler get to receive, which I like to do to start off.
The festivities are over, and we're just about set to get this
Moncrief
game underway.
Is going to take it.
He'll return it from the one, and he's
we're not going to get that much.
Let's check in with Reese Davis in the studio. Time to head for Raleigh, and for Tennessee, they grab a W in the season opener. For Ole Miss, Kirk Tick is inside the offensive coordinator's mind here and what he wants to attack against this defense.
The great strength of this spread offense is its versatility. You can attack in so many different ways if you have...
Okay, we got a guy wide open right there, so...
spread you out from sideline to sideline. We've got athletes at wide receiver. We've got a running back.
Start off the game this way, that's great. I like how we do it.
We also run the ball. It just puts so much pressure on a defense.
So the big game resulting from the pass
speed
play
option.
The first and 10. Wallace, options out to the left. He laterals the ball.
Scott, he's got the
Scott
two first plays and he's doing real good.
There on the option play.
I think he's a sophomore maybe.
From the 33-yard line, second down.
I have Wallace at quarterback because his first name is Bo, which is what I put as my coach's name. I will put him back. Let's go deep pass and then.
He might be playing a cat and mouse game here with a defense.
Try doing a screen.
Back to pass. That's a great tackle.
Not
gonna 31.
Get much.
So it's complete, but they didn't get much there.
And I don't know if he got injured on that play either.
Waiting on it, and they attacked. The quarterback should have found somebody else downfield.
Let's see.
From the 31-yard line.
Fullback.
Third down.
I don't know who the fullback is.
He makes it out
right,
to maybe
fourth
the
and one. We're gonna have to take a field
play.
Goal here. Nothing wrong with taking a field goal in the first game. In the first
so
game of the season.
Down. So the kicker comes out. He'll try to put 3 points on the board.
Oh, we lost Scott.
Is looking to go up by three.
That's not good.
It's
good.
Field goal. He didn't make it by much, but
47-yard field goal by Campbell. He's
career,
our punter.
But it did do the job. And like Brad said,
we're gonna be safe. Just in case. I don't want to lose Scott all season.
Campbell has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off.
This is
excellent kick.
Hope we have a great season. Like, we just started off right now, and we're doing pretty good, I think. Not bad for not the greatest team you can get on NCAA 13, but definitely a great one. Or definitely a good one.
inside handoff. Nice run.
We're
going to
let them get about 5 or 6 yards. First play for them. They're going to be speeding it up here, I guess.
Trailing around.
What? Oh. That should have been a sack, but, you know, whatever.
He did a good job of recognizing
I think we're doing pretty good.
For picking up the first.
He's going to want to run it again, but we get a stop right there. Defensive tackle. I'm going to leave this. He's going to QB spy.
The lineman got a little ahead of the snap count.
Here's the offensive lineman got a penalty. And he did. That's a boost right there for us. The Heisman mode isn't that hard, I gotta say. Oh, he's gonna go that way. We're gonna get him at 3rd and 15. Surprise, I thought they were gonna go try spinning it up right there, but they're not. I respect that. I'm going to try bringing the pressure.
He's looking for his man.
Oh, that should have been picked.
That was a nice play. Anything you can do without being penalized to prevent the offense from moving forward is always a plus.
I like doing this to help speed
like
up.
Doesn't have much time to get rid of this punt. Man, he took him down hard.
I gotta say, Moncrief isn't that fast. Maybe he just didn't get a good enough start running.
They'll take over at the 31.
We got Scott back in.
Ole Miss has a 3-point lead.
Oh. Kind of saw that coming. I should have went for a pass probably. Let's see if we got any good plays.
From their own 28-yard line, it's second down. Gives it to the back. Nice run there as they work
Scott
the outside.
Gets drilled.
Time for an update from the studio. Reese,
good game,
got?
Though.
The Bulldogs roll in today's game ranked number 6 in the nation. The Bulls have a lethal pass-catch combination for a touchdown.
And that'll do it. Very good first quarter of action. The Rebels with a 3-point lead.
I agree. That was a really good first quarter for us in the first year. Try doing a screen with Scott since he hasn't let me down so far in the start, and he gets out, he breaks the tackle, and we get a great game with Scott.
He looked pretty cool back there. Even with the outside linebacker blitzing, he made an accurate throw, and the result is
I'm gonna try going deep down the field since we haven't done it yet.
From the 48-yard line, it's first down.
Get past them on Creef. Good game right there.
There's very good chemistry between these two. They like to run through all their routes before the game. And I have to say, they look sharp before this.
I have a feeling
started.
I'm going to be going to Moncrief again.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 24-yard line. They're changing the play.
Oh, that was a good pass, I think. But accidentally audibled out of what I wanted to do.
From the 24-yard line, second down. Ole Miss is up a field goal.
That route. That's what I want to do. Okay, there we go. Oh, did not see that coming.
So I'm going to make them think third and long.
That I'm going to try screening here. Oh, I should have thrown that deep. I ended up throwing a quick pass, making it an interception.
That, ball. Well,
there, that was my fault. Nothing on
the
team
the
right there.
Made a great catch. From their own 19-yard line. First down.
Great hit by Prewitt. Oh, they get us on that fake.
He's up to the 30. Tackle around the 42-yard line.
That's what I don't like about the NCAA 13. They have the quarterback run pretty much every play.
Defense does with a five wide outlook. They'll give it off here.
That just made my guy run the other way. I don't know why that happened, but you know.
Option here.
Prewitt's gonna get that tackle again. I'm starting to like that guy. I'll have to look at him after the game. Look at his stats and all that.
Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, five wide receivers.
Just in case.
Quick pass, and he's tackled at the 38.
Thought he might have tried the option. Keep that quarterback spy right there.
He's taken down.
That was a great hit. You can hear the helmets collide.
Baylor will take their first time out of the half. That'll make it sick. And this is the eighth play of the drive.
I don't know if you guys noticed, but I like to press the crap out of everyone.
He drops back.
There's a guy wide. And
it
made, I don't know why they did it, but it's definitely made Prewitt go to the other side of the field when he came over.
From the 17-yard line, first down. Gives it off. They'll bring him down right around the 8-yard line.
Baylor's getting a good drive here.
That brings up second and one.
Let's see if we can get a stop.
Here's the option. Tries to pitch it and the ball is loose.
Interception. And I think Standifer has got this all the way. No one's going to touch him. We're going to take him for a touchdown. That's a boost of morale right there. I knew he was going to pass it if I just went to the right of him, and he did. And I'm happy Standifer was right there, ready for that. Yeah, real close to getting that score, and we got it.
Thanks, guys. The training staff just told me they are concerned he suffered a broken bone in his thumb. The injury looks to be pretty serious, and right now they're saying he will be out of action for a while. Brad, let's send it back upstairs to you guys in the booth.
Well, a big blow for these guys. Let's hope he's better and back on the field soon.
Turn that down just a little bit.
Campbell has the ball all teed up, and he's ready to kick this one off.
Good kickoff here.
Nice kick, plenty of distance.
Campbell should be pretty high draft pick, I think.
This one's gonna be down to
I think he'll be probably sixth round maybe next year if in the NFL. Depends on who else is out there. That's pretty good for us. Get Johnson out here.
He looks to throw on first down. Quick throw, and they
make the stop around the 27-yard line. Nothing going on.
They're
going
to hurry up. There's only 40 seconds left in this quarter.
That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield.
We're doing a great job this so far this year in our start.
And it looks like they might be bringing some pressure here.
And he wants to run out the clock. He's going to try doing some option, I think.
He's looking to pass.
We left the guy wide open.
Here's an update from the studio and Reese Davis. It's 3rd and 5. Ball on the 30-yard line. And we'll probably see how far he can throw it, as it should be the last play before the half. Looking to throw.
You get the sack.
The Rebels will use their first time out of the half.
I'm going to take a timeout. Maybe we have a chance at getting this punt for a touchdown. I don't want to be too greedy, but why not try? It's the beginning of the season. We'll see. We're going to test our team out.
And he just got drilled.
Nope.
We've reached halftime, and I don't think too many people were expecting this. 10-0, Ole Miss. A defensive masterpiece by both teams in the first two quarters. Will that be the case again? We're about to find out as we open up the third quarter. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Like I said, we're not the greatest team, but we're doing pretty awesome, I gotta say, against Baylor. But soon we'll have to face Alabama, LSU, and all of them. And that's, I know that's gonna be a fight. I don't know who is the running back. We got another one. Lord, our defense is just on fire. Can't get better than that. I would like to see my offense on the field. Campbell's going to get us the extra point. And Collins, the interception for a touchdown. I didn't think he was going to pass it. I thought he was going to try to run at the cornerback. But anyway, the quarterback tried lobbing it back to his running back and led in the second time on that same play for a touchdown for our defense.
This offense has got to try to pull.
I think my defense coordinator is going to stay here next year.
I know as a quarterback, it's always hard to watch the defense score a touchdown on you. But it was always a reminder to take extra care.
Collins almost got, well, it wasn't Collins, but someone almost got that pick. Golson.
Second and 10. Ball on the 25.
Next play.
Nice catch on that one. He's tackled at the 36-yard line.
Kind of messed up on that play. Not kind of. I did mess up. But here we go.
Great concentration.
And just keep going for that tight end. Get some real quick.
You cannot keep tossing it up into the secondary like that.
Real quick yards here for them. So they could at least try to get up. Oh. We're going to have a penalty on us. I didn't think I was actually in front of the yard that time, but in front of the line. Sorry, I keep messing up my words today.
Eugene
Grant.
It's 5 free yards, and that could hurt.
SMU destroyed that fake college 42-0. I don't know how long I'll be doing this dynasty, but we're doing pretty good. So maybe for quite a while I'll be doing this.
Brought down right around the 42-yard line.
I think he should be behind the line on that play, because we pushed him back.
Throws it to the halfback,
Collins is going to get him to slow down, and we get the tackle for only a gain of 1 yard for them.
Man coverage there, fellas, and that's why they stopped that screen.
Yeah, and when the secondary isn't dropping back into zone, it makes it difficult to have success with that kind of screen play.
He's on the run.
He's going to try running it.
He's got room. And down he goes at the 13.
He's going to get a good distance, but I don't care. I just want to see my offense
coming to the line. They'd like to
out there
in
a little bit. I
want to
see what they can do.
Off the scoreboard here.
He's just going to throw it away. I don't know why. I didn't see any pressure from us, but
this is the eighth play of this drive.
Whatever. As long as we get these plays, I don't care if they do bad.
They'll run it.
He breaks three tackles before he goes knocked out of bounds. That's insane. That reminded me of Adrian Peterson. We get the tackle behind the line. It'll be 4th and 3. And he's going to kick the field goal. Or not he, but Baylor will. Too used to playing online. And it's good. 17-3, third quarter. I think we got this.
He's lined up to kick this one off. Excellent kick.
We're not going to take that.
The offense will
see what I can
line.
Do with Moncrief down the field with Bo. Bo Wallace, I believe.
Wallace,
I don't see anything.
Now he's scrambling.
And I couldn't throw it away. Forcing me to get 2nd and 18.
So the sack makes this a 2nd and long. Throws it deep. Caught sideline.
And we get the catch inbounds. Nothing like a good big game with Moncrief. Try the option.
So the big gain resulting from the pass play leaves
good
us with a 1st and 10.
Run play with the quarterback. We're going to put Matthews over here. Hope gets a good block. And
option.
I tried sliding. I'm too used to the Madden when every you run it, you drop the ball, but I guess you don't drop it all the time when you're in NCAA.
From the 33-yard line. 2nd down.
Try running with Scott. We'll put Allen. He'll get some blocks. And we get destroyed in the backfield.
37-yard line.
3rd and 8. I know I'm gonna pass. I don't wanna. I wanna try taking a chance. I wanna make sure I got this game in the bag. Sorry guys, it's taking me a while. Oh,
he
gets sacked.
Brad, not only did they give up a sack here, but their quarterback just got hit and hit hard. If I'm an offensive coordinator, especially
in the
an
third
offensive
quarter.
Line coach, I'm getting a hold of my offensive line, making sure these guys are on the same page, and they've got to take more pride in taking care of their quarterback than that play right there.
They're just one quarter away. 17-3, Rebels.
I'm gonna go for it. Why not? Get us some stats.
Fourth and long here after the sack. He's changing things up.
Oh, we get sacked again. No offensive line, I guess, but we're still in the lead. I hope that wasn't the difference maker between the win and the loss. But.
I know we're only in week one, but this defense looks like they're in midseason form.
They come out of an empty backfield.
He's going to try and he's going to run it, and we get the sack. There we go. I'm going to try quarterback spying him.
Back to pass. Pass out to the tight end, but it's incomplete. Third down, and they need to get it down to the 39. It's absolutely deafening down there. Back to pass. Going deep, lays it out there.
He gets the playoff. I really thought we had that covered, but we're going to get the first down. He's going to run it.
Decides to tuck it in, and he's got space.
And he's going to get the touchdown.
Great call by the offensive.
That was a good play for them. Definitely not for us, though. I really expected high hopes of our defense, but we aren't the greatest team to start off the season. They wouldn't have had that unless I punted it. But I don't think they're going to get another touchdown.
He sends this one deep.
I trust my defense.
He's to the 10.
Moncrief is going to get to about 19. I don't know what I should do. I think I'm going to do some passing.
Things aren't tied, but they might as well be. It's this drive that could really dictate the tone for the last quarter. Ole Miss is up by a touchdown. And it looks like they're going to change it up here.
Sanders is wide open. He just doesn't want to hang on to it. He can't get any more wide open than that, but we're going to go try that play again.
From their own 19-yard line.
And hope he hangs on. Just hope. Or maybe I'll get a wide receiver open somewhere else.
He's going to go for the home run. Picked off.
Oh, I'm going to get picked off again by the same guy.
What is he thinking? The quarterback has got to know at this time in the game, unless his man is wide open, that he should just
throw
it away.
Down by seven. That was a stupid play by me. I should have been thinking smarter, but he has a chance. Baylor's got a chance to tie this game.
Now he tries to buy some time. And he's tackled.
Trying to get a forced fumble out of this guy.
When you decide to tuck it and run.
Keep,
on that play, it was
keep running with
the right
quarterback. It's not helping.
Nice game.
We get the sack.
Tailback.
Get stopped.
The 32-yard line.
And let's see if our defense.
The student section's going crazy.
Can get this. Oh, we leave him wide open.
Inside the 10.
It's a touchdown for them. We're gonna tie this game up. And now we have to think smart. We're gonna be running on the next drive. Just to make sure.
A little more than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. He splits the uprights with the extra point.
Let's see what our kick return team can do. Our special team can do to them.
He's to the 10.
I thought we were going to get out there. We're going to get out 19. Dante Moncrief is out. He is injured. That's not good for us.
They'll start this drive.
Definitely needed him. Let's see if we can get a good play out of this. Okay, we got 4 yards. I'm gonna try my favorite run play. The shotgun counter.
Second down and 6. Ball on the 23.
That's probably a holding. One doubt it. They always do that in the situations when you least need penalties. Yep, it's on us. I'm
going to
do some play action. I'm going
to
put him in. I don't care if I'm going to injure him the rest of the season. We need him right now, and he knows it.
It's 2nd and 13. Ball on their own 17. We'll wait and see here if he really does change the play.
And he's gonna be sacked. I'm gonna get sacked again.
Boy, this defense is doing a great job of bringing pressure. That time they brought up
hanging on to the ball way too long. I don't know what I was thinking I could have all that time.
He may have changed things up here. Quick toss.
I don't know what he was thinking, but he just throws it way too far over his head, making us have to punt. I'm not going to take a chance here, right at our end zone.
Campbell is the punter. And this one is a beauty. Williams fields at the 44. They'll bring him down at the 45.
They don't have the luxury of a lot of time. They'll need to go into a hurry up.
39 seconds left.
Step up and make some plays.
We might have overtime.
We can stop
them.
I know it. I could feel. I could feel it.
He's scrambling.
He's going to try scrambling again.
Slides down to the ground. The Bears don't like the looks of things. They're going to take their first time out.
I don't think it's a smart thing of them to take the time out, but whatever. I'll accept that. That gives me more time to get plays out and all that. Wait. And he's going
to
take another time out. I think I'm just going
to
let him score, maybe. That would probably be the best choice for us right now.
It's 1st and 10. Ball on the 15-yard line. Feeds it to the back. What a play, and that is 1st and goal. The Rebels taking their
take a
time
out
of the half.
You know that saying, get your keys out, because we're on a drive? This offense right now is on a drive. I mean,
I'm going to do this. Try to let them get a touchdown so I have a chance
really
at scoring.
To wear the psyche of this defense down.
They go with the
we're
going to
let
them
get him
it.
This might be a stupid. This might be smart. But you never know.
Baylor is up by 6.
We and almost got out. That would have been sweet.
This return man field the ball, and this is just a booming kick. He's to the 10. He's taken down.
He's
going to
get us out to the 25.
for Baylor, they've been getting into the backfield quite a bit.
We got a chance here. I'm gonna do what I like to do.
They also gotten them to turn it over twice.
When it comes down to these situations.
Well, they are running it pretty well, so that wouldn't be a bad thing. You take the yards however you can get them.
Throws it to coverage.
We throw our pick. Ah. We finally tackle him. That's going to be the end of the game for us, probably.
For this defense. They couldn't have picked that off at a better time.
Just a horrible decision by the quarterback trying to force that pass, especially at this point in the game.
And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the
ball. They kneel the ball.
Ole Miss will take their second time out of the half.
We're just going to let him kneel it again.
And
that'll be the end of the game, guys.
Take a knee to drain this clock and any hopes the opposition may have had.
Thanks for watching, guys. Baylor wins 24-17. I think we had a good game. I don't know about you guys. That was a good way to start the season off. We have an A-plus schedule, so it's going to be pretty hard to win these games, especially when we face Alabama. That's going to be a really hard game. But we just left too many people over, left them way open, just leaving them with a win. Made some stupid decisions too, just trying to go for it on fourth down. I should have been smarter and just took the punt. But yeah, this is how we're going to end the game. And thanks guys for watching.